So in last class we have done the features family of x86. These are the family members of x86 enter family, and then we started with the features of 8086, the very first microprocessor of this generation, and then we did a block diagram of 8086 microprocessor, where your microprocessor is now having two independent unit. One is bus interface unit and one is execution unit. Okay, bus interface unit is performing all fetching part, and it will fetch all six instruction. This is prefetch queue, where it will fetch six instruction ahead of time, and execution unit will take one instruction one by one from this prefetch queue, and both are working independently. So the speed will be double. Okay, so it is a dual pipelining structure. And we have seen what are the different parts, functions of each, and what are the main components or the parts in each unit, bus interface unit and execution unit. Now we have to do this physical address, how to calculate physical address. So as we have already discussed that this 8086 microprocessor is having 20 bit address bus. So means its address length is 20 bit, and this processor is a 16 bit processor. 8086 is a 16 bit processor. So if it is 16 bit, so it can store, transfer and process 16 bit data only. So if I want to store 20 bit address, so I cannot store 20 bit address in 16 bit register, because registers are also of 16 bit. So what they did that time, they divide the RAM or the memory into 16 segment. You can see from here this diagram, these are 16 segments, okay. This is first segment, then second segment, third segment, fourth segment, fifth segment, and this one, seventh, eighth, like that. So they have divided into 16 segment. So this is your memory capacity is 1 MB memory. Okay, so they have divided the 1 MB memory into 16 segments. Okay, so at a time, as we have already done, at a time 4 segments are active: data segment, code segment, extra segment and stack segment. So code segment is used to store the code of your program. Data segment and extra segments are used to store the data of your program, and stack segment will store some stack related, interrupt related things in your, if some functions you have called, the program counter address will store in this stack segment. So at a time 4 segments are active for your program. So how to get that 20 bit physical address and how to store this 20 bit physical address in registers with, whose length is of 16 bit. So as we have discussed that bus interface unit is having 4 segment registers: data segment register, code segment register. We did that now. I show you that part also. See, this is code segment, stack segment, data segment and extra segment. So these are the segment registers, okay. And what is the job of these register? The job of this register is to store the starting address of each segment, okay. तो हमारा जो सेगमेंट स्टार्ट हो रहा है, अगर वो इस एड्रेस से स्टार्ट हो रहा है, तो दिस एड्रेस, जस्ट लाइक द एग्जांपल इज गिवन फॉर कोड सेगमेंट, द स्टार्टिंग एड्रेस ऑफ कोड सेगमेंट इज गिवन 348A, ठीक है. तो दिस 348A, जीरो आई एम नॉट टेकिंग राइट नाउ, 348A इज द स्टार्टिंग एड्रेस ऑफ कोड सेगमेंट, दिस 348A, बिकॉज एवरी सेगमेंट इज ऑफ how many locations are there in each segment? That is 64 KB. We have divided our memory, 1 MB memory, into 16 segments, and each segment consists of 64 KB memory. So 64 KB can accommodate easily. That address can accommodate into this 2^16 is 64 KB. Okay. So this is this 16-bit address I can store in code segment if it is the segment of code. The so code segment starting address is 3488. Okay, your code segment is starting. So this will store where? It will store in code segment. Okay. Now if I want to move in this code segment here, somewhere in the middle or at the end of this code segment, then that address is maintained by a general purpose register, and for code segment it is maintained by instruction pointer. Okay, so the combination of code segment, which will store the starting address of each segment, starting address of code segment, and the offset address, the address within that segment, is stored by instruction pointer. तो ये दोनों 16-bit एड्रेस, ये भी 16-bit है स्टार्टिंग एड्रेस, और जो इंस्ट्रक्शन पॉइंटर का एड्रेस है दैट इज ऑफसेट एड्रेस, दैट इज ऑफ 16-bit. तो अभी इसको कंबाइन कैसे करना है कि जो 16-bit 348 है, इधर यू मल्टीप्लाई दिस विद 10, इधर यू मल्टीप्लाई दिस विद 10. So when you multiply 10 is in hexadecimal, so this will become 34880, right? Or you can rotate this address 4 times. So jab aap rotate karoge to bhi ye number yahan par aata hai, but better way to remember that you can multiply this with 10. So this will now, it will be now 5, and then instruction pointer, theek hai, इंस्ट्रक्शन पॉइंटर का एड्रेस मीन्स द एड्रेस विद इन सेगमेंट इज 4214. तो वेन यू एड दीज टू, तो 4214 शुड एड लाइक दिस, ठीक है. तो जब आप इसको एड करोगे तो दिस विल बी योर एक्चुअल 20-bit फिजिकल एड्रेस. दिस इज योर एक्चुअल 20-bit फिजिकल एड्रेस. तो दिस विल गो ऑन एड्रेस बस, ठीक है. तो ये काम कौन कर रहा है कैलकुलेशन का? दैट एड्रेस जनरेशन यूनिट. एड्रेस जनरेटर, आई शो यू दैट. दिस इज योर एड्रेस जनरेशन यूनिट. दिस इज डूइंग दिस वर्क. इट विल टेक 16-bit एड्रेस फ्रॉम कोड सेगमेंट रजिस्टर, दैट इज द स्टार्टिंग एड्रेस, एंड इट मल्टीप्लाई इट बाय 10, एंड इट विल एड द ऑफसेट एड्रेस और द address within that code segment, that is your offset address. ये sum करेगा दोनों को and it will send to address bus. So this way it will generate 5-digit or 5-bit address. ठीक है ना. 2^20 हमारा कितना हुआ? 1 MB memory. ओके, हमने 1 MB मेमोरी को क्या किया, डिवाइड किया कितने में? 16 सेगमेंट में. तो 2^20 को कितने डिजिट लगेंगे? 5 bits, ठीक है ना. 5 digits, जो 5-bit वी विल यूज टू रिप्रेजेंट. तो हमारा जो एड्रेस हो जाता है वो इस तरह से 5 digit 0002, जो कैपेसिटी होती है दैट इज FFFFF, ठीक है. इस तरह से ये 20-bit एड्रेस जनरेट होता है, क्लियर. तो दिस एड्रेस जनरेशन यूनिट ऑफ दिस बस इंटरफेस यूनिट विल जनरेट 20-bit एड्रेस बाय टेकिंग द स्टार्टिंग एड्रेस ऑफ कोड और स्टार्टिंग एड्रेस ऑफ एक्टिव सेगमेंट, मल्टीप्लाई दिस विद 10 एंड ऐड द ऑफसेट एट द एड्रेस विद इन द सेगमेंट, एंड देन ट्रांसफर टू 20-bit एड्रेस बस, क्लियर. So this is address calculation. This is not the part of your syllabus, but to understand what is the job of data segment, code segment, extra segment, and stack segment, you should know, because these registers will come in programming model. So you can write, and if you know the concept, then you can easily write that these are 4 active segment out of 16 segment of 1 MB memory, and each segment is of 64 KB, and segment registers are used to store starting address of each segment which is actually or currently active. Clear? So this way you can calculate. So this is explanation I have written in this slide. So the same which I have already explained, already it is given here in this. So you can read later on. Okay. So this way you can calculate physical address. Now next is basically the question which is there in your board exam. Draw and explain programming model of 16-bit x86 microprocessor. So in your syllabus you have 2 diagrams, one for 16-bit and one for 32-bit. The 16-bit version mein kaun se microprocessor aate hain? 8088, 8086 and 80286. Okay. So jaise humne 8085 ka, you all remember that what is the programming model of 8085. We have already done 8085 programming model in detail. So explanation humko aati hi hai. So bas usse hi related, similar sa, thoda sa, waisa hi hai. So kaise tha usme? Yahan par accumulator tha, here it was F and then B, then C, then D, then E, then we have H, then we have L, then we have program counter, and then we have stack pointer. Okay, so this is of how many bits? 0 to 7 and then from 8 to 50. तो 16-bit का ये प्रोग्रामिंग मॉडल था, वेयर ईच रजिस्टर इंडिविजुअली वी कैन यूज इज ऑफ 8-bit एंड यू कैन मेक द पेयर बी सी डी ई एच एल टू स्टोर 16-bit एड्रेस एंड प्रोग्राम काउंटर स्टैक पॉइंटर. सिंस दे आर स्टोरिंग 16-bit एड्रेस ओनली, तो दे आर एक्चुअली ऑफ 16-bit. यू कैन नॉट ब्रेक दिस. ओके, एक्यूमुलेटर एंड फ्लैग रजिस्टर कॉम्बिनेशन, यू नो what we call that PSW. It will store the result as well as status of your program. Understood? So this was the programming model of 8085. The same way we have programming model of 16-bit. Okay, so abhi aap isme dekhoge to bahut easy hai. Now it is very easy to learn for you this, because In this programming model, it consists of general purpose register. So in this you have 8 general purpose register. Okay, then you have segment registers. So now you are familiar with this word segment register, and then you have instruction pointer and then flag register. So this is very important diagram. Agar is chapter mein se मैक्सिमम जो पूछा जाता है वो 3 ही क्वेश्चन सबसे ज़्यादा पूछे जाते हैं. प्रोग्रामिंग मॉडल ऑफ 16-bit फर्स्ट, प्रोग्रामिंग मॉडल ऑफ 32-bit सेकेंड, एंड द फीचर्स ऑफ पेंटियम प्रोसेसर. और मैक्सिमम 4th क्वेश्चन आता है, एनी डिफरेंस और ज़्यादा करके 80286 और 80586 का डिफरेंस आता है. मैक्सिमम पेपर्स में यही 4 क्वेश्चन ज़्यादा करके पूछे जाते हैं. और एक फ्लैग रजिस्टर्स 16-bit का रेयरली, हार्डली कभी देखा है 32-bit का, पर 16-bit का फ्लैग रजिस्टर. तो ये 4 से 5 क्वेश्चंस ही हैं विच वी नीड टू प्रिपेयर फॉर फ्रॉम दिस चैप्टर. So since it's programming model, so first is your general purpose register. So as you know, what is the meaning of general purpose register? General purpose registers are basically used to store intermediate result of your program. So intermediate result store करने के लिए हमारे ये चार registers use होते हैं, ठीक है? A और ये जो है कंबाइन करके 16 बिट रजिस्टर है. फर्स्ट इज एक्यूमुलेटर, सेकेंड इज बेस इंडेक्स, काउंट, दे हैव गिवन द नेम एंड दिस इज डेटा, ठीक है? तो दीज फोर रजिस्टर्स यू कैन यूज टू स्टोर इंटरमीडिएट रिजल्ट. एंड दिस इज लोअर ऑर्डर बाइट एंड दिस इज एक्यूमुलेटर हायर ऑर्डर बाइट एंड एक्चुअली इट इज रिप्रेजेंटेड विद AX. तो AX इज बेसिकली इट इज 16 बिट एक्सटेंडेड वर्जन ऑफ एक्यूमुलेटर. क्लियर? एंड नाउ यू आर फैमिलियर विद दिस रजिस्टर्स ऑल्सो. तो दीज फोर रजिस्टर्स आर यूज टू स्टोर द ऑफसेट ऑफ योर एक्टिव सेगमेंट. तो अब कौन किसके साथ काम करता है? जैसे कोड सेगमेंट हमने देखा किसके साथ काम कर रहा था, इंस्ट्रक्शन पॉइंटर के साथ, ठीक है? तो स्टैक सेगमेंट किसके साथ काम करता है? स्टैक पॉइंटर के साथ. मतलब दिस एड्रेस, स्टैक सेगमेंट का जो स्टार्टिंग एड्रेस है, इट इज स्टोर्ड बाय स्टैक सेगमेंट रजिस्टर एंड इट्स ऑफसेट एड्रेस इज स्टोर्ड बाय स्टैक पॉइंटर, ठीक है? बेस पॉइंटर भी इसी के साथ ही, इसके ही रिलेटिव में स्टोर होता है. एंड डेटा सेगमेंट का स्टार्टिंग एड्रेस इज स्टोर्ड बाय DS एंड इट्स ऑफसेट इज स्टोर्ड बाय सोर्स इंडेक्स. सेम वे एक्स्ट्रा सेगमेंट में द स्टार्टिंग एड्रेस ऑफ एक्स्ट्रा सेगमेंट इज स्टोर्ड बाय ES एंड इट्स ऑफसेट एड्रेस इज स्टोर्ड बाय डेस्टिनेशन इंडेक्स. So I'll show you the explanation. You can draw this diagram very easily as well as you can write very easily with this. So don't leave this question. बहुत easily आप इसको लिख सकते हो and you can learn also. Now you can see the explanation. Here we have A, the general purpose register. AX, BX, CX, DX are basically used to store intermediate values during execution. ठीक है? And it is consist of two parts as we have already seen as AL and AH. तो एक combine करके हम उसको AX बोलते हैं. Then we have these four registers: source index, destination index, base pointer, stack pointers are 16-bit registers and they are called pointer register so that they can point to the location within segments. Okay? So this is basically, it is a pointer register which is pointing to the offset address or the address in the segment whose starting address is with segment register. Okay, so here you can see stack pointer. So what is the job of stack pointer? Stack pointers, stack is in stack segment used during instruction. So it is point to the stack top. Okay, base pointer kya karta hai? So maine ye bola tha na, dono register stack ke saath hai. It is pointing to the base top and it is pointing to the offset address of the stack segment. So these two registers or the pointer registers are pointing to the stack segment. So stack segment में आपके तीन registers काम कर रहे हैं. First is stack register which is holding the stack segment register which is holding the starting address of stack segment. फिर उसके बाद stack pointer क्या hold करता है? Top of the stack memory. And base pointer is basically the offset address of any location in stack. Source index kya karta hai? It is hold the offset address in data segment as I have already explained. And destination index, it stores the offset address in extra segment during string operations. Understood this concept? So these are 8 general purpose 16-bit register which you can use for different purposes. The first four, these are general purpose. It is used to store data temporarily during the execution of your program, and other next four, these are called source index, destination index, base pointer and stack pointer. Base pointer and stack pointers are used with stack segment, which will store the offset. Base pointer will store the offset of stack pointer, stack segment, and stack pointer is used to store the top address, or it points to the top of the stack. And source index will store the offset address in data segment, and destination index will store the offset address in the extra segment. Next is segment register. वो भी आपको पता चल गया है अच्छे से. All segments registers are used to store a starting address of each segment. So currently you have active four segments. What are they? Code, stack, and two for data. So code segment register जो है, it will store the base address of for the code segment. कि कहाँ से आपका कोड स्टार्ट, कोड सेगमेंट स्टार्ट हो रहा है. तो अगर ये यहाँ से स्टार्ट हो रहा है तो इट विल स्टोर दिस स्टार्टिंग एड्रेस. ओके. एंड स्टैक सेगमेंट इट्स सेम वे, स्टोर द बेस एड्रेस फॉर स्टैक सेगमेंट. डेटा सेगमेंट विल होल्ड द बेस एड्रेस फॉर डेटा सेगमेंट, एंड एक्स्ट्रा सेगमेंट विल स्टोर द बेस एड्रेस फॉर एक्स्ट्रा सेगमेंट. क्लियर. तो दिस इज अबाउट सेगमेंट रजिस्टर. Now you know the flag instruction pointer, we have already done. It is a pointer or the basically the offset address of your code segment. So it is a 16-bit register, just like your program counter. Okay? Why it is specially written over here? So it is basically a pointer to your program, because in your code segment you have stored your instruction. Program instruction. So it should be executed one after another. So just like in 8085, what is the job of program counter? Program counter is used to point the next executable instruction of your program. Same way here also in instruction pointer, it is a 16-bit register and it holds the offset of next instruction in code segment. And it is incremented after every instruction byte is fetched. Okay, understood. And what is flag register? So just like in your 8085, there you had five flags, and here you have nine flags. Five flags are same. जो आपने 8085 में five flags किए थे कौन-कौन से? That is sign, zero, carry. I'll write in sequence. First was sign 0, then we have auxiliary carry, then we have parity, and then we have carry flag. Okay, so it will start from here 0, like this space 1, then 2, space 3, then space 4, then 2 space 5 and 6, like aise chal raha hai na, isko maine gadbad ki hai, ek space hai. This will be 6 and this will be 7. Okay, so these five flags are also the part of your this 16-bit register, and four more flags are there to tell the status of microprocessor. So this theory also you need to write along with this diagram. So ye aise hi aata hai, draw and explain the programming model of 16-bit x86 microprocessor. So there you first draw the diagram, then you write about how many parts are there. So it has three parts, so general purpose register, segment register, instruction and flag register. So first you write about all eight general purpose register, then write about segment register, and then write about instruction pointer and flag register. Understood this? Clear hai abhi hai? So same way you can write for 32-bit also. क्या difference है 32-bit में? अभी यहाँ पे memory भी तो बढ़ गई. अगर 32-bit version है तो address या तो 24-bit या 32-bit address हो गया. तो 4GB memory आपकी you can access. Okay? If your address bus is of 2^32, so you can access 4GB of memory. But the concept of segment registers are same. you need to convert into 16-bit addresses. Okay, so 16-bit addresses में convert करने के लिए अभी यहाँ पर एक extra provision दे दिया कि instead of 4 active segments, now you are having 6 active segments. So you need 6 segment registers मतलब you can use 6 segments at a time. Okay, so code segment will remain same, stack segment will remain same, extra segment will remain same, data segment is same like your 16-bit version. Now you have 2 more segments for data. You can store means all 2 more 64 KB memory is memory available for your program. Okay, so at a time 6 processor jo hai, 6 registers are active. Okay, Shishit, no problem. Okay, तो 32-bit version में आपको 6 segment registers होंगे. तो this is the first difference between 16-bit and 32-bit. Now here you can see same you have 8 general purpose register and but these all registers are of 32-bits. ठीक है, instead of 16-bit now you have 32-bit. So you can say now the names are different. EAX, extended of accumulator, extended of base, extended of count, extended of data. And same way, जो आपका बे ऑफसेट एड्रेस स्टोर करने के रजिस्टर्स हैं वो भी 32-bit हैं. बट सेगमेंट जो मेमोरी डिविजन का कॉन्सेप्ट है वो अभी भी कैसा है, इट इज़ ऑफ 64 KB. And each starting address of these segments are stored in segment register. But instead of 4 segments, now you can have 6 active segments at a time. Instead of 2 data segments, now you will be having 4 segments for data. Clear? So you can learn this diagram, practice this diagram, and same way you can divide your explanation in 3 parts. First part is general purpose register, where you will write about that these are 8 general purpose registers and all are of 32 bits and you can store in this 3 version, 8-bit, 16-bit and 32-bit model. But then each can address, you can store 8-bit version, 16-bit version and 32-bit, means it has backward compatibility. And what is the use of segment register? So segment registers are basically used to store starting address of each segment. So it has 2 extra segments for data. And same way instruction pointer, it is basically a pointer in your of your program, just like your program counter in 8085. So it is a 32-bit register and it is also hold the next executable instruction in code segment. Same way we have flag register. So there in 8-bit you were having 5 flags, 16-bit mein kitne the, you were having 9 flags, and in 32-bit version you have 15 flags. ठीक है, 16 होते हैं वैसे, बट एक फ्लैग जो है ये IOPL ये कॉम्बिनेशन में काम करता है, तो हम इसको एक ही कंसिडर करते हैं. इसके 4 ऑप्शंस बनते हैं प्रिविलेज मोड का. ये मीन्स IOPL का क्या टेल यू, तो इट हैज़ 4 मोड्स, 0001 1011. तो बेस्ड ऑन किस मोड में आप काम कर रहे हो, तो दिस वे यू हैव 32-bit flag register and out of 32 bits, 15 flags are there to tell the status of 32-bit microprocessor. So in this you can say these, it has 15 flags that helps change or recognize the state of the microprocessor. Understood this? Yahan tak clear hai sabko? Is it okay to everyone? So So these this we have done 16-bit microprocessor model of programming model. Then we did 32-bit programming model and understood this part.